Hey, can you hear me on the broadcast now? Hear me now? Can you hear me now? Oh, Indian cities.
Hey, this is Mark DeRosa. Welcome to the show.
Okay, here we go. Let's go now.
Hey, get ahead. Stay ahead right here.
That all games this season. Since 1980.
All right, here we go. Okay, here we go. Let's go.
Your attention, please. Nothing is impossible when we all stand together.
We've got baseball for you from Guaranteed Rate Field on the south side of Chicago. Tonight, it's Conquest Baseball between the Indians and the White Sox. It's going to be a premier pitching matchup. Two of the league's hardest throwers go head-to-head next. In is Torrey Hunter, and we are ready for some daytime baseball.
Leading off for the Indians, the right fielder, number 48.
Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. Now a fastball gets the upper part of the zone for strike two.
That pitch is in triple digits. I think he had to take that one because I'm not even sure he saw it.
Well, this will be taking it out there at short, and that's the first out of the inning.
Batting second.
Into the box, Ken Griffey Jr.
Ken Griffey Jr.
Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. And he lays off there, 1-0. And a great day for baseball here. 81 degrees at first pitch. And it's a ball and a strike to Ken Griffey Jr. Now the 1-1 pitch is looked at for ball number two. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball.
And obviously, this guy's a double threat up there. He can run, and he can go yard, too. You don't want to walk him because he might steal a base on you, but you don't want to groove a fastball either because he could take you out of the yard.
And he lays off here, ball four, and he'll become the game's first base runner here with one away.
That is third.
So one gone in the inning here with a runner at first. And that brings up the big bat of Vladimir Guerrero Jr. First pitch coming, here it is. And a called strike down in the zone, nothing and one. Slapped hard the opposite way. In there, a base hit. And with that, the go-ahead runs up to second now with only one away.
Batting four.
So first and second with one man gone. And up steps the power bat of Peter Alonso. Here's the first pitch to him. And he swings through a fastball and doesn't catch up with it. It's 0-1.
That's straight smoke at 99, guys. It's almost unfair.
0-1, here it comes. Behind 0-2 now. Hit in the air to right field. Waiting on it is Jimenez. He makes the play. Runner tags and heads for third. And he'll take those extra 90 feet, so put runners at the corners now with two gone in the inning. Coming to the plate now, Matt Carpenter. And he could give his guys an early lead if he can come through here. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Down the left field line and deep. And this will wind up a foul ball. Comes set, the 0-1. Line drive, base hit to right. The runner from third crosses the plate, and they've taken a 1-0 lead. Now in the box, Ernie Banks.
The shortstop, Ernie Banks.
He's set, here it comes. Called strike at the letters, 0-1.
Hey, he finds himself in a tough situation early, and he's going to have to execute a pitch to get out of it. But if he does, it'll build confidence, and he starts rolling as the later innings start happening.
Behind 0-2 now. Ready on 0-2. Line to the right side.
Jimenez
is there, and he'll make the catch. Next to bat will be the Cuban import, Yoan Moncada. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Third baseman, Yoan.
And a first pitch sinker is over for strike one. And this is hit hard to the right side. Foul. Here it comes, 0-2. Smoked on the ground left side. And this will get through into left for a leadoff hit. Up next for Chicago, Leury Garcia. As the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here. Now a fastball that couldn't quite find the zone. It's ball one. That's by him for strike one.
Hey, that was a nasty pitch right there. It's the depth of a sinker. Sometimes it's a matter of whether or not it's moving east-west, but that one right there had such good downward action. Great pitch.
The 1-2. Hit back up the middle. Scooped up on the backhand. Wow, a flip to second for one. The relay not in time as he beats the throw by a step.
That's shortstop.
First delivery to him on the way. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. Runner goes for second. That's a strike, the throw down. Not in time as the offline throw allows him to get in there easily. And there's a line drive, base hit to left field. Throw comes in quickly now, so that tying run will be forced to hold on at third here, still with only one away.
The first baseman.
He'll start him with a sinker here, but that sinks a bit too much that time. It's 1-0. And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now.
With two strikes and the runners at the corners, this is a big pitch coming up. Got to execute and hope to either get a strikeout or a double play ball to help you get out of this thing.
So he racks up the swinging strikeout on the breaking ball. Jose Abreu becomes out number two this inning. Two balls and a strike.
Well, I know the last thing he wants to do is load the bases right here, so the pressure is on right now to get back in the strike zone.
He got him. And exhale as he's out of the jam and the inning is over. Now at the plate, Garrett Anderson. He'll get us started in the top of the second.
The left field.
Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. And here's a fastball called for strike one. Well, fans of good pitching are in for a treat today. What can we expect from today's matchup, guys?
I know everyone loves the long ball, Matty. But this is why I pay the price of a ticket right here. Two of the game's best, two of the hardest throwers competing at the top of their game. Dan, you have to love this stuff.
You know, D-Row, we thought coming into this one it was going to be a low-scoring affair. Both of these pitchers look like they're locked in early, and runs are going to be really...
A swing and a drive to center field. That one's got a chance, and he's going to make the catch on the warning track. A fine running play there for the first out. Now at the plate, Jason Kendall. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. On, he pops it up. Abreu in foul ground, and no one will track it down. Line to the right side, but this will hang just long enough for him to run it down in shallow right for the second out. Michael Brantley is into the on-deck circle as it appears he will bat for Felix Hernandez here. Right there for strike one. Line toward the gap in left center. Garcia will get there, and he puts it away. Number 70 will take the ball now as the new pitcher.
Number 70.
Leading off the inning, James McCann, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up. Here's the 0-1 pitch. That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2.
When you have two strikes on you, as a hitter, if you get something that you can handle, you have to find a way to do some damage with it. That was a missed opportunity.
Swing and a miss as he couldn't connect on the two-seamer, and that's out number one. So one away here with the bases empty. And that'll bring in the left-handed hitting John Jay.
Okay.
Swung on but fouled off to the left. Hit on the ground to third. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. And the effort pays off as he's able to recover and get the second out of the inning. Ready now for the White Sox. Number 20. He'll get his first shot with the bat here. And a strike called at the knees. Nothing in one. And a pitch up and in, keeping him honest. One and one.
Well, that two-seam fastball ran a little too much off the plate, but now that sets him up to work with something away and maybe even an off-speed pitch.
Got him swinging, and that will... Stepping in, Corey Hunter, 0 for 1 for him here in this one.
The right fielder.
First pitch of the at-bat. Timing just a tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right. One strike now to Hunter. Behind 0-2 now. Hunter is really a rare talent in this sport. A true five-tool player, as they say, which means he can make an impact in a game at any time. Really a joy to watch, not someone you want to take your eye off of.
Yeah, this guy's worth the price of a ticket. Just to watch his tool set, but not only that, the way he grinds at the plate, the way he battles defensively, this guy is one of the true superstars in our game.
Center fielder, number 20.
Striding in, Ken Griffey Jr. He worked a walk and came around to score in his first trip in this game. Ready with the first pitch, here it comes. Good bite to the slider, and he takes strike one.
Is that gun reading right there? Because that just registered at 91 miles an hour on a slider. If he's working that pitch, that's most guys.
Here's a swing and a long drive high in the air and deep to center field. And this one is gone, a home run. So the bases are clear now following the home run. And set to go is the third baseman, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. And that's inside for a ball, 1-0. Bottom part of the zone, a good changeup gets the call. So 1-1. It is a fastball down below the knees.
Wow, it just doesn't seem like he's being as aggressive as he was before he gave up that home run. Was throwing the ball great. Now it seems like he's a little bit more tentative throwing the ball across the plate.
That gets through, and he'll reach base again on his second base hit of the game. Digging in, Peter Alonso. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
You know, guys, these hitters have had some great looks at that slider so far, and clearly they're all on the same page. The plan is simple. Lay off that slider and make him bring up something straight in the strike zone.
Too high, and it's 3-0. And a good comeback there. It's 3-1. And this misses for ball four. The second walk he surrendered here in the first three innings. Aaron Bummer comes on now in an awfully difficult situation as there are two on here with nobody out. Matt Carpenter will be his first test out of the bullpen, and it'll be a tough test indeed as he'll face him with two on and nobody out here. Slider bends into the middle of the strike zone, taken for a strike. Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call. Two balls and a strike to Matt Carpenter. This is lined to left. But he'll hardly need to move out there in left as this is hauled in for the first out. Stepping into the box, Ernie Banks. Hit it hard, but lined out in his first at-bat.
Yeah, he hit it hard. That's all you can ask. You can't control the result sometimes, Matty. Just unlucky with the placement.
They'll try and entice him with a high fastball, but he wouldn't commit. It's ball one.
Looked like he just tried to do too much with that fastball right there. He overthrew it a little bit. That's pretty much the case when you airmail a fastball like that.
2-0 now. Two and one now.
That fastball must have a little late life on it because that was right in the wheelhouse and he still wasn't able to get good wood on it.
He's set and the 2-1 pitch. Hit hard on the ground towards second. Barehanded for one. On to first as they get the... Yolmer Sanchez will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number five.
Mark Melanson, a 6-foot, 2-inch right-hander, jogs in to take over on the mound.
Mark Melanson.
0-1, here it comes. Drops one down here, and he'll try to beat it out. And he will smartly swipe that ball away in foul territory, so we likely won't see the bunt again now with two strikes. And it's fouled away. Another 0-2 home. And another foul ball. The next 0-2. Weakly hit towards first. Alonso has it, and he'll step on first for the out, three unassisted. One out here in the Shy Sox third, and that'll bring up the former top prospect as a minor leaguer, Yoan Moncada. In there for strike one. Oh, can't spot the cutter any better than that. Nothing in two now.
That wasn't a terrible pitch right there, but if he's going to execute and get this swing and a miss, he's going to have to get that ball a little bit further down, maybe even potentially bounce the next one.
Here's another 0-2. And that is swung on and missed, and things are starting to look bleak here for the home nine. There are two away now.
Leory.
Way inside with that one, a pretty easy take there. Two balls and no strikes to the White Sox left fielder. Late that time for a strike. The White Sox down to their last strike. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over. In a close game like this, you look for that one guy who produced when it mattered. Tonight, the contest. Welcome in live from Yankee Stadium. This is it. Torres digs in looking to end this one with one swing of the bat.
No doubt, Maddie. Everything is on the line right now. This is baseball at its best.
2-0 now. Ball three as he misses low with it here.
Walks are never good, but they're especially bad news late in games like this. It seems like they always come back to bite you.
Full count now, 3-2. A possible winning run on second. No one out. And another foul ball. Hit hard on the ground at first. Alonso is there, and it's a productive first out as that runner is able to advance 90 feet up to third here.
Up next for the Yankees.
Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu, and he could very well get the intentional pass here as that would set up a potential. Double play ball that might keep the game tied. No swing on the knuckle curve, even at 1-1. 1-2 to DJ LeMahieu. Swing and a fly ball, and that should be deep enough to end it. Catch is made in medium deep left center. Here comes the runner for the plate, and the Yankees are going to walk off as winners. We've got a contest. Welcome in live from Yankee Stadium. A great game has come down to this. Looking for any way to manufacture a run. Torres steps in with the opportunity to be the hero.
This is what you hope for every day you come to the yard, to have a chance to win one for the boys.
Now the 1-2 pitch. And that misses 2-2. And this is swung on and missed. And boy, they took care of a key man there. One away.
The first baseman.
Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu, and he's got a chance to bring in the winning run. The question is whether they'll even pitch to him.
Now batting.
And he starts him out with a strike on the outer half.
Hey, when you're in a tough spot right there, that's an excellent job by the pitcher to get ahead 0-1. He has now got this offensive player on the defensive.
Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away. Drops in a strike to start the at-bat. Nothing in one. Outside for a ball, 1-1. And he fouls this one off. Possible winning runs at second with two down, however. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2. Never tempted to swing at that ball down low. It's ball three.
Well, no doubt in my mind, this has been the at.
This ball's down, and that could bring in a run. And the Yankees are going to walk off as winners. Tonight it's a match. We are back live. Here we go. Bear in mind, small ball is in play. Torres comes forward with a chance to win it with one swing.
And you have to tell yourself not to try and do too much. Slow the moment down and hit the ball hard somewhere.
Two balls and a strike now to the Yankees leadoff man. Swing and a ball hit high in the air, deep down the left field line. This has plenty of carry. And a great diving effort there, but it'll just tip off his glove, and it's a base hit. Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu, and he has a great opportunity to win it here. Winning run at third base, nobody out.
You know, guys, sometimes guys don't like pulling the trigger 0-0. They want to see something go by, calibrate the speed, calibrate the break, and then make their adjustments off that. Maybe that's the case right here.
This is foul right side. And he'll look at a called third strike, and that winning run will hold it third with one big out on the scoreboard. And it looks as though the decision makers in the dugout will give him a free pass to first, so the bases are loaded here on the intentional walk. And the force play is now in order. Giancarlo Stanton stands in as he can't connect here. 0-1. Now the 0-2 pitch. Struck him out. A huge punch out there. And the winning run stays anchored at third with two gone now. 0-1 the count. Here's a cutter that's off the plate. 1-1. Grounder hit hard down the first baseline. But a foul ball, 1-2 now. And a good pitch here, but this is taken for a ball as the count moves to 2-2 now on the Yankee catcher. And he comes back to get him, so a great job pitching out of it. We've got a contest. Now batting, Josh Donaldson. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
The third baseman.
Josh swung on and missed for the first strike.
Donaldson.
A 1-1 count now to Donaldson. Good breaking ball there. Laid off for the second strike. 1-2 pitch is a slider that misses. 2-2. This one sinks low and a touch outside. It's a full count, 3-2. Ozzie Albies is on deck. It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. But it bends just foul into the second deck. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And that'll bring up the exciting Ozzie Albies. Too low, 1-0. And a fastball here that's taken for ball two. Hit hard to third. Guerrero right there. Throw in time at first for out number two. And here's Ronald Acuna Jr. now. Looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive. Squared that one up just a little late. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Hard hit ball to second. Carpenter has it. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired.